It's time for bed, Dee Dee. Go hop in bed. I'll be right in to tuck you in.
Good night, Daddy. What are you doing here? My mommy's coming. You better hide, or she's gonna catch you.
Okay, sweetie. Night, night. What are you looking at? Now promise me you'll be a good girl while I'm out singing.
I promise.
No sneaking out this time. I'll get in trouble.
I promise.
That's my good girl.
Mommy, is Daddy ever coming back?
I don't know, honey. Maybe someday when he's ready. But don't you worry. Mommy always comes back. I'll be home before you even wake up. Get some nice sleep.
Okay, she's gone. She's gonna sing at the Ghost Note tonight. It's the most beautiful cabaret. Come on, we'll miss her show. Oh no, somebody moved the ash cart. Look. I know. You could go down there and move the ash cart, and I could jump down. I'll play here, so you can go over there and be a shadow person. Come on, go over there and do your shadow check. I could do that. Could you teach me how to do that? Okay, now move the ash cart to where I can jump into it. I wonder who moved it. Do you think it was Mommy? She got really mad at me the last time I snuck out. Where did you go for so long? I haven't seen you in 3 weeks. I really wish you had been at my birthday. Daddy missed my birthday. Now we go this way. Follow me. Oh, I think you're too big. I think that goes all the way through to the other street. If I move this cart, you could walk up to Shadow, couldn't you? They haven't started the show yet. You missed the dancers. They were so beautiful. I want to be a dancer when I grow up. Or an acrobat, like you. Did you always want to be an acrobat? You're so good. Come on, let's go in.
Want to put on some lights? I promise you'll like the view. Come on, sugar. Help a girl out here. We can't play in the dark. Hey, one's on the frizz. Hey, Sparky, could you do something about that one, too? It's really messing with our rhythm. Charlie, would you?
That's Daddy.
What are you doing here?
You're singing good tonight, Ken.
Don't smooth talk. Johnny, we had an agreement.
Is that what you call it? I never wanted to leave. You kicked me out.
You want money from me, Johnny? Because I'm ducking the landlord.
I don't need a handout, babe. Look at this suit.
You work in another one of your famous deals?
This one's big, Kat.
Oh, sure it is. Till it blows up like last time and the time before
Not
that.
Not this time, babe. I'm going to make it all up to you.
I got to get back on stage.
Then meet me after. I'm staying at the Excelsior.
But you think you're just going to jitterbug your way back into our lives with a lot of sweet talk?
It's going to be better this time, babe. You're going to see how much better it can be. Room 529, kiddo.
Where is he going? I need to talk to him.
You
He just went through the gate. I bet he's going to the bar. Mommy said Daddy left us, but that's not true, is it? She kicked him out. It won't open! But you could break it open. You're pretty strong. Come on, it's this way. That's the amazing Vincenzo. He's a world-famous illusionist. What's Daddy doing with him?
Come on, Vincenzo. It's just some film footage of your act. Why can't you let me borrow it just overnight?
Because it is my new act and it's top secret, which is why my agent has it safely locked in his office upstairs.
I just want to show it to my investors. They want to get to know you better.
Mr. Fenris, I have performed my illusion act for the King of England and the Emperor of Japan. There are untouchables in India who tell stories of the amazing Vincenzo. If your investors don't know me, they're not in show business.
You think I can't pay you? Look at this suit. I'm staying at the Excelsior Hotel.
I've asked around about you, Mr. Fenris. People tell me not to trust you.
And I've asked around about you, Mr. Amazing. You're not as flush as you look. You've got a few debts. Which is why I think you'll perform at the opening night of my circus.
You dare accuse me?
Look, I made a beautiful poster. Now I just need to borrow your film reel.
Until I see some earnest money from you, I'm damned if I will lend you the time of day.
All right. I'll get you a check.
Cash.
Cash, don't worry. I'll call you tomorrow.
It's been such a pleasure meeting with you. Thanks for the drink.
Thank you.
Daddy's gonna get into trouble without that movie reel. We have to get it for him. Daddy's gonna get into trouble without that movie reel. We have to get it for him. Daddy's gonna get in.
Where are you going?
Daddy went in there. Daddy's gonna get into trouble without that movie reel. We have to get it for him. get into trouble without that movie reel. We have to get it for him. Get the movie to him. I think he's going to the cinema to meet his friends. Mr. Fenris, I have performed for the King of the Universe. There are monkeys who know about the amazing Vincenzo. If your investors haven't heard about me, they're stupid. Oh no, there's no way to get across. I know. If we could get the spotlight working, then I could track you with it. But it's out of power. We need some luminaires. Do you have any? Too far. Can you help me, please? I told you I was good at fixing things. Maybe you could find another way in.
Dee Dee, what are you doing here? You're not supposed to be out this late. Where's your mom?
Did Mommy really kick you out?
Were you spying on us at the cabaret?
Are you coming home?
Well, that's my plan. I've got to convince your mother. She here?
No, I snuck out.
Oh boy, you're growing up fast. You used to be scared of the dark.
But did she really kick you out?
Well, yeah, kinda. At the time, I wasn't being very good to her, so I guess I had it coming.
I missed you so much.
I missed you too, honey. But I'm gonna come back home. I'm putting together a circus, see? It's gonna pay for everything. And you know who it's gonna star?
The amazing Vincenzo.
How much snooping around have you been doing? Yeah, it's gonna star the amazing Vincenzo. He's good, huh? Look, you're really not supposed to be out this late. I'm gonna take you home.
I brought you the milk.
I got a couple of investors coming here, and they don't like kids much. I need you to run home by yourself, okay?
But I brought you...
Dee Dee, you have to get out of here. I won't tell Mom you snuck out. Okay, go.
Hey, Carmine, Silvio.
He doesn't have the money to show them.
His name is Salvio, so why are we here?
Salvio, yeah, what did I say? I got great news. Vincenzo is in.
You got him? You're sure?
Sure, I'm sure. He's gonna play opening night. Really bring in the crowds.
So that's why you brought us here, huh? You're gonna show us his act?
Yeah. Yeah, except the projector's broken.
Because if you don't got him, your circus is gonna flop and you're not gonna be able to pay us back.
And then I'm gonna have to break your arms and then we see how well you swim.
Look, I'm gonna need just a little more money to finalize things with Vincenzo.
Are you kidding me? What'd you spend that money on, that suit?
Listen, it's all gonna come back to you.
Show them the movie! Show them the movie!
Knock it off, Sal. Check this out. Geez, he is amazing.
I told you I got him.
Okay, let's go get your money.
Thanks a bunch. Look, why don't I swing by tomorrow and pick it up?
Relax. Let's go have a drink, huh? I know a guy who'll fix that finger right up.
I can't. I gotta go meet someone.
Boy, you're in a hurry, huh? She must be a real ripe tomato. You wanna go meet Johnny's tomato, Sal?
I like a ripe tomato.
That tomato's my wife.
Always wanted to meet the wife. We'll play canasta. Just the four of us.
Okay, but...
He's not asking, Johnny. He's telling.
You're gonna hurt my mom.
Getting pretty loud in there.
See? You meet a guy's wife, now he's got a whole new reason to make good.
How come you know so much?
Cause my ma used to smack me every time I didn't know.
I should try that with my kids.
Maybe you could sneak in through a window or something. And then you could let me in.
Why'd you have to come back, Johnny?
I want to come home, Kat.
And you got another pot of gold at the end of the rainbow?
That's the past, Kat. I've changed.
Oh, yeah? You get religion?
I got lonely. I miss you, baby. I'm never gonna give you another reason to kick me out, I swear.
Never's a big word. Feels like I heard it before.
This time you're gonna be nothing but proud of me. Look at this hotel suite. I got investors.
The ones who just left? Yeah, I'm real proud. They the ones who broke your finger?
This? It's nothing. I got it caught in a desk drawer. In a door. In a car door.
Remember the horse doctor you were gonna fix?
You don't believe a word you're saying. I know, because I can read your mind like a highway sign.
No, Johnny. Not again. You're a carousel of broken dreams. You keep coming around and around.
No one is ever gonna love you like I do, kiddo.
Get back! Don't try and kiss me, Johnny. I'll lose my mind.
You gonna shoot me? Ah, go ahead and shoot. I got two holes in me where you and Dee Dee used to be. Put another one in there. Finish me off.
What do you want with Dee Dee? You're not even her real father.
What, you think Vincenzo's real? All he ever gave Dee Dee was her cute little nose. Yeah, maybe I'm not her real father, but I'm the one that showed her how to tie her shoes. I'm the one that put her to bed when you had to stay out late. You took her to see his show. Did he change his mind? He doesn't want to be her father. He doesn't want to be anybody.
I hate you.
Jesus, Cal, what are you doing?
Mommy, stop! What are you doing?
Nothing. Mommy and Daddy were having a little fight. It's not a real gun. It's just a toy.
Yeah. Yeah, it's just a toy, Dee Dee.
Mommy, are you gonna let Daddy come home?
Dee Dee.
Please, please let Daddy come home.
He's in pretty deep with some bad people, Dee Dee. Maybe he should make good with them first. Right, Johnny?
Maybe I'm no good without my family. Maybe I need my family to make good.
Johnny.
Yeah, Daddy needs us.
If this is another train wreck, it's not just gonna be you and the train this time.
I'm not gonna let it wreck this time. I promise.
I've missed you so much.
Yay! Daddy's coming home! But he's not my real daddy, is he?
Been. Did you know the circus is in town?
It's Daddy's circus. He says it's gonna be the biggest thing ever.
Except he always says stuff like that, and then something goes wrong. And Vincenzo's my real daddy. We have to go talk to him. They're so happy. There aren't any pictures of the bad times. These are in the basement. She only takes them out when Daddy's living with us. You know, in stories where the little girl is really a princess and her parents aren't really her parents? Does she still get to see them? It's an eviction notice. Daddy says he's gonna pay all the bills when the circus is a big hit. Come on, I want to go find Vincenzo. I don't think they'll hold you. You'll have to go through shadows. Come on!
Hey, Vincenzo. Ready for our big night? People are really excited.
You're gonna have to give them their money back.
What? We're sold out.
You haven't paid me.
I got the money. We're selling out. You'll have it before the show.
Even if you do, I can't perform here. Your circus is a disaster.
It's coming together.
Your puppet show about the princess is missing the princess. You've lost your hot air balloon, and where did you get that pirate ship? It is a broken-down piece of junk.
Come on, Vincenzo. It's opening day. There's always a few wrinkles to iron out. Look, I'll get it all fixed. No problem. Consider it done.
All right. But don't think that I will be some sort of shiny bauble that lures people into your scrapyard.
He's so mean.
I'll get it fixed, I promise. Or I'm a dead man.
I'm worried about Daddy. He always says it's okay, but those gangsters really hurt him. We have to fix the circus, so Daddy will be safe. Come on, it's this way. There's the balloon. It got snagged so they can't pull it down. But nobody can get up there to untangle it. I bet somebody didn't pay attention when he was tying it. I think we just need a carousel. I think I can turn it on. Do you have any luminaries? I think I can turn this on now. I think you're gonna need to get that beacon working. Yeehaw! Woo!
okay up there? You need any help? Here, jump on this. I think you're gonna need to get that beacon working. Okay, now you can get up to the roof and untangle Daddy's balloon.
Teach me someday?
Hey, has anyone seen the princess puppet? We can't really start the story without her.
That sounds like Daddy.
She was right here. There she is. Once upon a time, there was a princess who lived in a castle with her father, the king. The king loved her very much because daddies loved their daughters. Unfortunately, the kingdom also had an ogre who was eating travelers because ogres do that. So the king did what kings do and promised that anyone who slew the ogre would get to marry his only daughter, the princess, and become king when he died. The king's lands were very far away, and the ogre was very large, so only one knight showed up. His name was Fred, and he fell immediately in love with the princess. Fred was a brave knight, and he marched off the next morning, singing a brave song as loudly as he could. After several days had passed, the princess got to wondering what had happened to her future husband. So she set off into the forest to look for him. The princess tracked Fred's footprints through a strange wilderness full of scary sounds and hidden dangers. Chasms filled with razor-sharp bamboo. Fortunately, she was a very brave princess who loved adventures, just like you. She used her wits to get past unexpected obstacles. She came to a wide river filled with snapping crocodiles. She couldn't even swim. So what do you think she did?
She ran on top of their heads.
That's right. It was a magical forest where the plants seemed to know each other. She had to use magic mushrooms to get high or up. Unfortunately, she impaled herself on the bamboo. Wait, that's not what happened! Unfortunately, she impaled herself on the bamboo. Wait, that's not what happened! She learned to use some bendy tree branches to fling herself across a patch of deadly sharp bamboo. As the sun was setting, she came to the giant ogre's campsite. And there, the princess discovered that the ogre had captured Fred and hung him from a tree as a snack. The ogre did not appreciate visitors at all. Even Fred seemed a little embarrassed to see her. The princess was a woman of action, and she was nimble, and the ogre was clumsy and easy to taunt.
What's a taunt?
That's when you make fun of them. You should never make fun of people, but with ogres, sometimes you have to. And so the princess tricked the ogre and rescued Fred. Fred didn't feel too good about it. He really loved the princess. Fortunately, the king told him about a giant spider that he could slay in order to win the princess's hand. So Fred marched off to the lair of the giant spider, singing a brave song, a little less loudly than before. After several days had passed, the princess got to wondering what had happened to her future husband. So she went off looking for him again.
Darn! Where did I put her? Ah, there she is. The king. Fred was a brave knight, and he marched off the next morning, singing a brave song as loudly as he could. After, the princess tracked Fred's footprints through a strange wilderness full of scary. Unfortunately, she impaled herself on a bamboo. Wait, that's not what happened!
She came to a wide river filled with snapping crocodiles. She couldn't even swim. So what do you think she did?
She ran on top of their heads.
That's right. It was a magical forest where the plants seemed to know each other. She had to use magic mushrooms to get high or up. She learned to use some bendy tree branches to fling herself across a patch of deadly sharp bamboo. As the sun was setting, she came to the giant ogre's campsite. And there, the princess discovered that the ogre had captured Fred and hung him from a tree as a snack. The ogre did not appreciate visitors at all. Even Fred seemed a little embarrassed to see her. But the princess was a woman of action, and she was nimble, and the ogre was clumsy and easy to taunt. That's when you make fun of something. You should never make fun of people, but with ogres, sometimes you have to. And so the princess tricked the ogre and rescued Fred. Fred didn't feel too good about it. After several Fred's footprints led her into a dark and creepy cavern, full of strange dripping sounds, kind of like the basement at school. Her footsteps echoed and echoed until it sounded like someone was following her. Unfortunately, she impaled herself on the bamboo. Wait, that's not what happened. Soon, she came to a vast pit filled with vicious, deadly spikes. It was much too big to jump over, but far off, she could hear moaning. She thought, it might be Fred. So what do you think she did?
I know.
What?
She used an umbrella.
What?
Like that nanny in that movie.
This is the Middle Ages, honey. Where would she get an umbrella?
I don't know, but that's what she used.
I don't think I have an umbrella.
Well, you better find one, because she used an umbrella.
Where am I supposed to get an umbrella? There we go. So the princess bravely threw herself into the air, slowing her fall using an umbrella, just like that nanny in the movie. She floated down into the cave, deeper and deeper into the cavern she floated. She thought she could hear Fred moaning, but maybe it was only the wind. Deeper and deeper into the cavern she floated. She thought she could hear Fred moaning, but maybe it was only the wind. Unfortunately, she impaled herself on the bamboo. Wait, that's not what happened! Deeper and deeper into the cavern she floated. Unfortunately, she impaled herself on the bamboo. Wait, that's not what happened! Deeper and deeper into the cavern she floated. She thought she could hear Fred moaning, but maybe it was only the wind. Unfortunately, she impaled herself on the bamboo. Wait, that's not what happened! Deeper and deeper into the cavern she floated. Unfortunately, she impaled herself on the bamboo. Wait, that's not what happened! Deeper and deeper into the cavern she floated. She thought she could hear Fred moaning, but maybe it was only the wind. Finally, she landed softly, right in a spider's web. Fortunately, it was a very old web, and she was able to break free. Unfortunately, the web was the only thing holding up a giant boulder. The princess needed to find somewhere to hide. A giant spider jumped out of the shadows and attacked her. She ran and climbed and jumped and climbed, but the giant spider was very good at climbing too. It had 8 legs and the princess only had 2. Remembered how the webs were holding up boulders.
Poor spider.
Finally, she found Fred. He was all wrapped up like a present for the giant spider's girlfriend. He was dreadfully embarrassed about having to be rescued again. He really loved the princess. The princess decided he was cute. Fortunately, the king told him about a dragon that he could slay in order to win the princess's hand and stop being so embarrassed. So Fred marched off to the mountaintop of the dragon, singing a brave song very quietly. After a few days, the princess got to wondering...
why her dad kept trying to give her away?
That too. But she was worried about Fred, so she went off to find him. The dragon's mountain was cold, and the wind howled at her to turn back. There were rock slides and fiery chasms, but she was very brave and nimble, just like you. She wasn't going to be put off by a few deadly dangers. And up she climbed. When she got cold, she thought about the hot buttered muffin she would make once she got Fred home. Do you still like muffins?
I love muffins.
The princess hoped Fred liked muffins. When the princess got to the lair of the dragon, she was not very surprised to see Fred hanging from the roof of the dragon's cave. So she taunted the dragon until it roared its fiery breath at her. That were tying up Fred. And so the princess and Fred lived happily ever after. Fred never had to go on another adventure again, and they had hot buttered muffins every morning. There is another version of the story where the princess flew off on the dragon's back to have a life full of adventures, but that's for another day.
went straight on till morning. Isn't the bow supposed to shoot it again? you big squid. Go find a whale to pick on. We can get out that way. Oh, I bet there's nothing actually broken. I bet it's just something you forgot to turn on. Vickers, Daddy bought it. I bet there's just like one thing he forgot to do, and that's why the whole ride isn't working. It's probably in the control room, or the engine room, or something like that. Come on, it's dark out there. How are you gonna climb on shadows if it's dark? Hey, this is that maintenance room I was talking about. I think we can restart the whole ride. I knew it. I knew it was something simple. I think all we need to do is pull these levers at the same time. Are you ready? Okay, 3, 2, 1, go! I think we fixed it. I think we fixed the whole thing. Came back.
Hey, what do you think, Vincenzo? Did you ever consider trying out for the trapeze?
They're good at what they do, Mr. Fenris. I'll give you that.
I got my balloon back, I got a princess for my puppet theater, and my pirate ship is sailing the bounding main.
So you're a man of your word.
Go ahead. Count it. It's all there. Need a hand with your stuff?
My apparatuses are very delicate, and I don't like anyone in my workshop. Provide the audience, Mr. Fenris, and I will provide amazement. Mr. Fenris, why are you organizing this circus? I know who your investors are.
I promised my wife and daughter I'd clean up my act.
But if I don't pull in the crowds for you, those boys are gonna put you in the river.
Without Cat and Didi, I wouldn't care much if they did.
Ah.
So those crowds better come.
I didn't talk to him. I didn't talk to Vincenzo. Vincenzo's going to a secret workshop. I can finally talk to him all alone. But where is it? Do you think he would ever take me with him? Vincenzo, you know, when he travels all around the world. Now we go this way. Follow me.
Bad people, Dee Dee. Maybe he should make good with them first. Right, Johnny?
Maybe I'm no good without my family. Maybe I need my family to make good.
Johnny, if this is another train wreck, it's not just gonna be you and the train this time.
I'm not gonna let it wreck this time. Promise.
I've missed you so much. He's in pretty deep with some bad people, Dee Dee. Maybe he should make good with them first. Right, Johnny?
Maybe I'm no good without my family. Maybe I need my family to make good.
Johnny, If this is another train wreck, it's not just gonna be you and the train this time.
I'm not gonna let it wreck this time. Promise.
I've missed you so much. He's in pretty deep with some bad people, Dee Dee. Maybe he should make good with them first. Right, Johnny?
Maybe I'm no good without my family. Maybe I need my family to make good.
Excuse me, mister. Do you know where Mr. Vincenzo's workshop is?
Yep. Everybody knows where it is. It's by the big clock tower. You can't miss it. But good luck getting inside. No one's ever been.
Thank you. Come on! This is a big mechanism. I hope you brought some luminaries with you.
Thank you.
What are you doing here? Who are you? How did you get in?
Through the big clock.
You went through the clockwork? How? Who are you with?
It's a puzzle, right?
It's meant to keep strangers out.
It's a very good puzzle.
Not good enough, apparently.
But I'm not a stranger. I'm Dee Dee. Dee Melancholia.
Oh. Your mother put you up to this, didn't she?
She thinks I'm doing my homework. I wanted to meet you.
I didn't ask for a child, all right?
You didn't want a child?
What would I do with one? I'm a busy man. My apparatuses are precise. They take months to hone. How would I have the time? That is what I told her.
I'm sorry.
I travel. I'm going on tour for 6 months. Budapest, Istanbul, Calcutta, Shanghai. I dine out with dukes and gangsters.
But I could help you with your apparatuses. I'm good with puzzles. You could train me. I won't be any trouble.
You broke my left-handed induction coil. That took me a week to tune.
I'm sorry.
I told your mother all of this years ago. What is her phone number? Okay, see? This is what I'm talking about. This is what I can't have. Your mother cried every week. You're better off with Kat. A little girl should be with her mother.
Okay.
All right. Do you want to come to see my show?
No!
Well, here's two tickets in case you change your mind.
Okay.
Let's get Kat on the phone,
What do I do with you? Lock you up? Put bars on the windows? I can't stay at home all night and watch you.
I know.
I'm not one of those secretaries who punch out at 5. I'm a rising star, right? Did Johnny know about this? Because I'm gonna kill him.
I just wanted to talk to Vincenzo.
I never should have let him back. I just need it. Just wanted.
And now, ladies and gentlemen, the amazing Vincenzo's Theater of the Unreal.
I knew it. I knew this was another one of Johnny's pipe dreams. You screwed up again, didn't you?
Johnny, what's going on? Is this part of the show?
I got it.
They're getting antsy. They're gonna want their money back.
If you give them their money back, you can't pay us.
It's all under control. I just gotta go find a spare ball. Fuse. Something.
Why can't he get anything right? We're gonna have to fix this one too. We need to light up the stage somehow. This is a weird lighthouse. Do you think it's some kind of science lab? It reminds me of Vincenzo's workshop. I think this is what lights up the lights up there. Let me see if I can fix it.
After a few days, the princess got to wondering.
Why her dad kept trying to give her away?
And now, ladies and gentlemen, the amazing Vincenzo's Theater of the Unreal.
I got the lights on.
We'll talk about this after.
Ladies and gentlemen, a physicist named Albert Einstein tells us that our universe may not be the only one. There may be infinite others, each slightly different from ours. What our dreams in our world may be reality in those. To citizens of these other worlds, we are shadows. This appears to you to be an ordinary box, but it is actually what we call a tesseract, or an octachoron. Suppose I open it, not in the three dimensions we live in, but along its fourth dimension. I can take out surprising things, things that are familiar and yet strange. But in this world of shadows, what seems familiar may be dangerous. What you don't know can hurt you. But what frightens you can also turn into something of surpassing beauty if you only understand it. Thank you. Thank you very much. Goodbye.
What are you up to, Johnny? You're up to something, aren't you?
I tried, Kat. I really tried. Mom was right. I made a lot of promises I couldn't keep.
What is with you?
Without you, I'd be in the river.
But it worked out, Daddy.
I nearly got you hurt, kiddo.
You would have saved me if I needed it.
Enjoy the show.
I want you to meet the little girl who turned the lights back on.
You made the lighthouse work?
I fixed the puppet show, too, and the pirate ship.
You fixed the pirate ship?
It was only a little broken.
See? She's almost as smart as you. Of course, she's brave, too.
What's that supposed to mean?
That you're rich, famous, and afraid of a little girl.
What would you have me do, Mr. Fenris? Take her on my world tour, take her to Shanghai and Istanbul and those other filthy and dangerous cities as some sort of apprentice? Is that what you came here to propose?
Daddy, no!
I don't know, just... Dee Dee deserves better. They both deserve better. They need you.
I think they need you.
Me? I'm a walking calamity.
No, Daddy, we need
you. You risked your life to be with them.
Johnny, what did you do?
He nearly got himself killed to get you back. I wouldn't do that for anybody.
But I'm just gonna keep screwing up.
I can help you fix things.
Would you take me back? For good?
Oh, Johnny.
Yay!
Would you like to see my workshop? Again?
Yeah.
I bet you get to Shanghai on your own steam.
But how?
Well, you'll figure something out. After all, you... are my daughter.
How'd you do that? I thought only Dawn could do that.
It's been a long time, hasn't it? Thanks for taking care of Dee Dee.
No matter.